done.
There we go. Ooh, yeah. Coming up in the world. Now, you know what? Now this tie is a souvenir. Now I got to frame it. Maybe at the Smithsonian one day. I got proof that you touched it, man. This interview is brought to you by the Pro Fight Shop in Hollywood. I am here, Radio Rahim, at Wildcard Boxing Gym with the Hawaiian Punch, Brian Viloria. Brian, it's, you know, we've known each other so long.
A while, man. I haven't seen you in a while until I seen you here last time.
But. You haven't seen me, but I've been watching you, and, you know, you've had a phenomenal career, and you're only going further. First of all, you know, you're so young, you fight with so much energy, and you're in your 30s now. Talk to me about what it's like to be able to maintain the conditioning to fight at this level the way you have for so long.
Yeah, you know, I had to stop eating. I had to start eating right, and you know, I start from there. You know, and you know, just having to stay in the gym and stay focused and just maintain the passion for the sport, and you know, if you have all those things down, then all it looks easy in the ring, you know. So I mean, you make it look easy, and for all of that, I just stopped drinking and stopped partying and start doing the necessary things for me to get myself in shape and try not to stay out of shape for too long, and you know, just being busy.
Now, you bring up the drinking, the partying, like, you know, it's kind of been a life transition. Yeah. Was there a time when you could have left the sport? Was there a time when the focus was so off that, you know, maybe you were going to go a different direction?
Oh, there's many times when my last loss against Carlos Tamara, a lot of people's like, I think it's time for you to retire. You know, you had a great career, and when I, you know, you do a lot of soul searching, and you just, you know, ask questions about, to yourself, saying, do you really want to, you know, hang it up at this on this note, or do you still feel like you have a lot more to prove? And when I looked down, when I dug deep, I just felt like, you know, I still had a lot more to go. Yeah. And, you know, and I still had the passion for it. And so, you know, I just continued to make the right decisions and the correct adjustments in my life. And you know, just continue on going and doing the things I like doing.
You know, it's a good thing that you did, because I feel like, after that change, you may have become more popular now than you were in the first half of your career. You know, that fight that you had with Marquez in November, you unified the titles. It was right here in LA in your backyard. It was a war. You know, it became an internet sensation for people who weren't there. Talk to me about that moment, knowing what you'd come through and knowing that you rededicated yourself. How satisfying was it to unify those titles?
Very satisfying, and to do it in such, you know, on that note, I feel like my whole career has been renewed, you know, to that point. But you know, for the last couple of years, I've been fighting that. If you look back at the Segura fight, you know, that was a fight where I wasn't supposed to be in there with him, and you know, a fight that nobody gave me a chance. And so for me to defeat a guy like Segura, and then to come out and to avenge a loss against Nino, and to, you know, fight against Marquez the way I did, it just, you know, it just told me that I was doing the things in my life correctly, and I did the right moves, and I'm making the right decisions in my life. And so I'm trying to continue on with that, and hopefully in this fight it's gonna be the same thing in April 6th.
Now, you're taking this fight international. You know, I expect you to be as big a sensation over there as you were here in LA in November. I guess, tell me what it's like to have now, I guess, the titles, the long career, the still with the passion, but what do you have left to prove?
That's what I ask myself every day. You know, just for me, my goal right now is just, you know, making the top 10 pound for pound ranking, and you know, I'm almost cracking that. And, you know, I think there's like a couple more fights. I really didn't want to just, you know, leave off being a footnote, you know, in the sport. I really want to make my mark and be remembered as a great fighter, and that's what's, you know, that's what's keeping me up right now, and just having fun. You know, I'm genuinely, like in the last couple of fights, I had fun and enjoyed myself, and you know, you feel really alive when and you know, when I'm in the ring and fighting, and that's where, you know, I feel like I was born to do, and that's where I belong. And so just finding that and you know, just enjoying myself and just trying to be, you know, just trying to be the best I could be, you know, even at this age, that's what's pushing me right now.
Now, no matter how dedicated a fighter or athlete is, when you're in your 30s, you got to start thinking like you're thinking, legacy, time clock, how much time do I have left to get accomplish what I want accomplish? Do you have so-called something of a hit list that you think could take you to the place that you want to be before you, or, you know, step out of the ring for the last time?
I'll know when it's time for me to hang it up. I don't know, when I wake up one day, I'm like, okay, I think it's time for me. And when that time comes, then, you know, I'll be able to, you know, just it'll be easy for me to hang it up. But right now, I just feel like I got a lot of ways to go, and there's no hit list. There's, you know, the guy. Yeah, I'm taking it one fight at a time, you know, at this point, and hopefully, you know, try to make every fight exciting from this point on, and that's what, you know, I promised myself, you know, after that Carlos Samara fight, just to prepare myself well for each fight, and just got to make it exciting, you know, got to make it worthwhile for the people to come out and tune into the TV, or come out and you know, take that extra cash out of their pocket to watch you fight, you know, just give them a reason why, and I think that's what I'm doing right now.
Now, I got a little footage of you earlier today hitting the bag, or, you know, the big mitt, I guess we would call it.
Yeah, the shield.
The shield, yeah. Cracking the shield. Yeah. The power that you still have and the power that you've had through your whole career, it's phenomenal. It's really, you know, for you to be so, you know, small in stature, your power is that of a big man. How is it that you generate that power and speed and have been able to maintain it over these years?
It's all, you know, the technicalities and just all, you know, the way you throw a punch and... I think I've been born with it. You know, some people are just born with ability to do such things, and, you know, to move their body in a way that it could generate, and, you know, enough torque for the power to come out. But it's all, you know, years and years of experience and practice and doing it over and over and over, and the repetitiveness of the sport has just got me to this point. Yeah.
Now, the main event in China is going to be a debut. It's only going to be a 4-round fight.